In this video, we're going to demonstrate how to set up and use the Google Authenticator mobile app for multi-factor authentication, also known as MFA. First, you'll need to navigate to account.wsu.edu and log in with your network ID, or NID, and your password. On the following page, you'll find all of your WSU account settings, including your password, security image, and, most importantly, your multi-factor authentication options, which are listed in the box titled Extra Verification. To edit these settings, navigate to the top right of this page, locate the green Edit Profile button, and select it. This will prompt you to re-verify your password. Enter it into the field and select the Verify button. If you currently have any other MFA methods activated, you'll be prompted to select one of them on the following page. Any MFA options that you have set up will always be accessible at login by clicking the drop-down arrow to the right of this MFA icon. In this case, we'll choose the voice call method and select the call button. You should get a phone call almost right away, providing you with your unique code. Enter the code into the field and select verify. Once you've authenticated, you'll find yourself back at the account settings page, where now all of the settings are unlocked and able to be changed. Navigate back down to the extra verification panel and select the setup button located next to Google Authenticator. On the following page, select the Setup button. Select your smartphone type, and on your smartphone, download the Google Authenticator app from your device's specific app store. Once you've downloaded the app, go back to the Setup screen in your browser and select Next. Open the Google Authenticator app on your smartphone and, at the bottom of the screen, select Begin Setup. Now you have two options. The quickest way to finish setting up is to select Scan Barcode. This may prompt a notification on your smartphone asking to give camera permissions to the app. Go ahead and give it permission, and then use the camera inside of the app to scan the barcode on your computer screen. The other option is to select Enter manually, which is handy if your phone's camera isn't working or if you just don't want to give another app camera permissions. For this, you'll go back to your web browser and, right beneath the barcode, select Can't Scan, and enter the one-time code and your WSU email address into the Google Authenticator app. Once the barcode is successfully scanned or the code is entered manually, return to the setup window and select the Next button. Now you'll be required to enter the unique code generated by your Google Authenticator app. You'll notice that the codes provided are time sensitive, meaning each code generated will display for about 30 seconds before it expires and is replaced by a new one. The timer icon to the bottom right of the code indicates roughly how much time is left for this current code, and as it gets closer to running out, the code itself will turn red. And don't worry if you aren't able to enter the code in time, as the new one is always just a few seconds away and will be immediately usable. One last note on this. For these kinds of time-based authentication methods, it's always a good idea to make sure that the time and date on your mobile device is set to sync automatically. Sometimes, if the date and time are set manually, they can be off a bit and cause issues when trying to authenticate. Once you enter the code, select the Verify button, and there you go. Your Google Authenticator MFA settings are configured. You'll be automatically taken back to the account settings page, where you might notice that all of the settings panels are still unlocked and editable. To lock them up again, navigate to the bottom of the menu panel on the left side of the window and choose Sign Out. Okay, now that our Google Authenticator settings are configured, let's demonstrate what it's like to actually use this MFA method when logging in. Head over to the MFA test site at mfa.it.wsu.edu. This is a really neat tool for simply testing your various MFA settings. It's set up just like the usual WSU login screen, so let's select our new Google Authenticator option from the drop-down menu and go back to the Google Authenticator app on your smartphone to get the required code. We'll enter it into the login screen, select the Verify button, and success! Looks like our Google Authenticator settings are working properly. So that's how to set up and use the Google Authenticator option for multi-factor authentication. If you still have questions about how to set up the Google Authenticator app, reach out to the Crimson Service Desk at crimsonservicedesk.wsu.edu, or check out the self-help article links in the description below. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to ITS on YouTube so you can stay in the loop about videos like this one and more.